Yo, what's up? It's Patrick from Guy in a Cube, and live stream we did. Someone asked a question. How do we add a column to a direct lake model? The calculated column is not enabled in the model view. Nope, you can't do it. At least you can't do it right now. Not to say that Microsoft's not working on something to help this. And I know you probably read the title and he was like, oh, just some clickbait. Patrick's not gonna show me how to do it because it's not possible. It actually is possible. You just may not like the way that I'm gonna show you. And what I'm gonna talk about is doing it as far upstream as possible. Then I'll work you through the steps as you get closer to the semantic model. We actually did a video, Matthew Roach, Roach's Maxim. He came up with this, he coined that. And so Matthew did a video on our YouTube. Go check out that video, you should go watch that video. And so I'm gonna explain how you add the calculated column that's created in different places to your semantic model. So you know how we like to do? Enough of all this talking, let's do what? Let's head over to my laptop. For this particular video, I'm gonna talk about this from the perspective of a warehouse or lake house, because they're both in direct lake mode. And so if you wanna add a column to them, if I go into my model view right here, we're gonna go into my model view. This is what they were saying right here. You'll see that you can't, it's disabled. It's there, so maybe one day you'll be able to do it. I don't know. You just can't do it today. But how do you do it? So let's say you're working with Excel, for example, as the source. So what you would do is you would go over into Excel. If you have access to the spreadsheet, and it's simple. So I'm gonna work with a table that looks like this throughout the video. You have your customer ID, you have your first name, last name. Everybody's probably like, Patrick, we know how to do this. Well, I'm just, you know, maybe somebody doesn't know how to do this. Click your column, ampersand, double quote, ampersand, last name. Boom, drag down. And so now I've added that column in my source. I know we talk about SQL and relational databases a lot, but if you're using Excel or a CSV file or some other type of file, you can go and add that for every row. Maybe a lot of work, but you absolutely can do it. So let's say SQL Server is your source. I like this new Management Studio, I think it's 21 version that's in preview. I'm using this one. So let's say you have a table that looks like this. So let's make sure we get our table created and we're gonna add a few rows. And so we have our table, and what we'd like is that same calculated column. What should you do? If it was me, if I don't have access to this database, I'm going to talk to my DBA or database developer or data engineer and say, can you give me this column? Can you materialize this column some way so when we go through our ETL process, we can persist it in our warehouse or our lake house? And that person may go, sure, I'll create a view for you. And I'm like, yeah. And so they would create a view in SQL that looks like this. So it's select all those columns, and then they would add a calculated or computed column that concatenates that for me. And so I'll create that view. So I'm gonna create that view. And as the person that's bringing that data in, I'm using Dataflows 2 as my ETL tool, Dataflows Gen 2. So I'm gonna go into my data flow. And what I would do is I would make some changes here. But before I do that, I'm gonna go over to my lake house. And you can see I've already created my table in my lake house. But what I would need to do is go back and add that column. And so you can do this lots of ways. I'm going to use Spark SQL because I'm just more familiar with Spark SQL. I have been learning Python, but I couldn't quite figure that out. But here's my alter statement. I'm going to run that. It's adding that column. If I go back over to my lake house and I refresh this, what you're going to see is that new column is added. Then I go over to my Dataflows Gen 2, and you see I'm going to lake house or warehouse. So let's just use the lake house. And so right now it's pointing to that table, the original table, which only contained those two columns. What I'm gonna do is change this to point to the view. So I'm gonna go VW underscore, and then I'm gonna get rid of the S because I forgot to put an S, and then click away. And if you just give it a few seconds, you'll see that new column is added. Now, what you're gonna do is go here because my destination is a lake house. And I really like this about Dataflows Gen 2, how I can specify different destinations for the different queries. Anyway, so now I'm gonna go here and go next and go next. And then what I'm gonna do is see my destination has that new customer name. And so, boom, that has my customer name. And I'm just gonna save my settings. So now I've updated the mapping. And then when I publish this, and it'll run and it'll load my data into my model. When it finishes, I'm gonna go to my notebook. So let's just run a query. So I'm gonna run this query. And then what you'll see is that the data is all loaded, including that new column. So I've added that new column to my lake house. Steps are very similar for the warehouse. You go add the column in your warehouse, change your data flow, change the mappings, and run the load, and it writes it to the data warehouse. And you may be thinking, well, Patrick, My DBA says they want to persist that column to the table as opposed to creating views because we need it. And I'm like, all right, you can do that too. All you need to do is if you're using SQL Server, instead of doing the create the view, you all to the table and add that column. Then they need to run an update statement to set the values of it. Then you select it, then it's out. Or they can add a computed column like this. They can do this first name, or you got to put in parentheses, first name. It's just like the update statement plus last name. So you do something like this. So they can add a computed column to the table. And so whenever rows are inserted, that column would automatically be assigned to the result of that computation that you're using to compute, okay? So they can either add a view, they can add a computed column, or they can add an actual column, which you'll need to run an update afterwards to make that happen. You can also do this in your Lakehouse. So if you go over to your notebook in your Lakehouse, once you alter the table, add the column, if the data is not being pulled in, if you don't want to update your ETL, you can make this part of your ETL process. So you can say update that table and set the customer name to a cat. And so you wouldn't use the exact same syntax as T-SQL. That's not supported. In Spark SQL, you would say customer name, concat these two values. Here's what I'm delimiting these values by. So it would be first name, space, last name. There's lots of different options. And that's what makes me excited about Fabric is that regardless of the persona that you are, you can actually get this done. Patrick, my data engineer won't create the view. My data engineer won't create the computed column. They won't add a column and modify the ETL. What do I do? Well, it's exactly what we talked about in that video where Matthew was saying, you just go what we've been doing forever. You use your data flows. You go to the ETL process and you modify what you're using to bring it in. I know you need access to all of these things. So hopefully you have access at this point to modify the ETL. So if you go into your data flows, you would add a new column. And so you go here, type examples. And so column from examples from all columns. And then what I'm going to do is give an example of what I want it to look like. I mean, we've been doing this for a long time, right? And so you can see, boom. And then you give the column a name, change your mappings, and then you load that into the Lakehouse or the warehouse. And now you have that new column. I know you want to create a calculated column, just not supported right now, but you can definitely do it. You go upstream and then you start working your way up. And then you're thinking, well, Patrick, how do I get it to show in my semantic models? I'm going to close this. And then I'm going to go over to my semantic model. See, I've created my semantic model. You go here, you choose open data model. If that's not in go to your workspace settings, go to Power BI General and choose users can edit data models. Okay, I had unchecked it, but regardless, go here, open my data model up, and then what you would do is, let's close, let's get us a little real estate back, choose edit, and then you expand it and click fetch in schema, and then click confirm, and that new column should show up. Now, I will tell you, a few times I've done this and it didn't show up, but there you go. There's my new customer name column. Now I can use it in my semantic model. I know you want to create a calculated column using DAX, or you want to modify the model and get it to load. But if you're the person that's designing the ETL load with Power Query, just add a column. If you have access to the source, whether your source is Excel, whether your source is SQL, go and create a view. If you can't create a view, add a column, whether it's a computed column or just a regular column, but you need to make sure you run an update to populate it and then run the refresh of your ETL to load that data into your Lakehouse. You may have to run some updates there also, or your warehouse, but then that column is available and then you just refresh the schema and your semantic model will be updated to include that new, I guess it's not a calculated column, I guess it's a computer column, but you need it, right? It's a computation of other columns in the same table. All right, what do you think? You got questions, comments? I'd love to know. You know what to do. Post it in the comments below. I'm actually watching the comments, okay? If you want to learn more about Power BI, Fabric, all the workloads, probably a video flying above my head. And as always, from Adam and myself, thanks for watching. See you in the next video.